something a wife does to her husband's face. Maybe I'm thinking wrong, but number seven. Welcome to Family Feud.
I'm a colon and rectal surgeon.
Rectal. Just the guy I've been wanting to talk to. This prostate exam. You know, with all of the technology that's available to man today, why? I want to take this finger right here. I want to push it in your eye right now, JD.
Can I make a recommendation?
You have a recommendation.
I have a recommendation.
I am listening.
Find a surgeon with small hands.
Gene, how you doing? What do you do for a living, sir?
I'm a gastroenterologist.
Are you serious?
Yes, I am.
You're not just gonna stay in that area. Huh? So y'all on one end, he on the other end.
Right.
Y'all just all up in here. I put it down there, y'all take it out. That's jacked up, man. That is so jacked up. The hell y'all laughing about? That's good.
And as part of my job, Steve, I have to do prostate exams. And
you have to do what?
Prostate exams. Part of what I do is
you
part
do the
of my
prostate
job.
Exam?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely.
Where your office at?
Come out to East New York, Brooklyn.
Ladies and gentlemen, my new doctor. Hey, Carla, name a small place where a big couple might have trouble making love.
I have a hard time in the...
Let's go to question two. Give me Carl. Give me some. Never felt this small before. I'm actually nervous right now. Name something you'd never do in public that you do freely at home. Ben.
The sex, Steve.
You do it freely, yes, yes. The sex, Steve. Name something bad about a guy that doesn't show up in a photo.
He has very small private parts.
We asked 100 married men, name your wife's most unappealing habit.
Flatulating.
Huh?
Flatulating. Passing gas.
Once again, was I the only one who did not know what she was talking about? Flatulating. Name something people do sitting down.
A magic carpet ride.
Hey, good answer! Yeah!
If that's up there, I'll eat your time, man.
Hey, let me tell you what Mike said. Mike said, hey, good answer, good answer. He turned to me and said, if that's up there, I'll eat your tie. Here's your chance. Something which the more you have, the more trouble you're likely to get into, Big Rob.
I would say property.
Yes, property.
Property houses. You have so much, it's like taxes, and you have to worry about all that nonsense.
Yeah.
Steve, it's up there.
Oh, sure it is.
It
is. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at my face. Just give me a word that rhymes with spanky.
Panky. Panky. Puh. Anky. Puh.
I love this guy. Panky, puh, panky. For the win, panky! You're Italian.
I'm Italian, huh? Oh.
Well.
Oh. He got you, didn't
gotcha.
He? That's how he got you. It was Getty the Playboy.
No.
Okay, I'm sorry. I was just throwing it out there. Okay. Just doing jokes. Ladies, we got the top six answers on the board. Name something a person might say is in the toilet. Janice?
How about their pee?
How about what?
Poop. This is a door.
Name something a person might say is in the toilet.
Their accent.
You don't want to start this. Their accents.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Name something a person might say is in the toilet.
We're gonna go with career.
Career has three syllables now. Snoop. We're gonna go with career! What would you do if you found out your man once acted in an X-rated movie?
I'd watch it. Yeah. Come on, baby, be a fair.
Okay, she watch it.
God, I've been wanting to do this so bad. Oh my God! You like it? You like it, baby? You can scratch too. I watch you all the time, every day. I do not miss you at all. And I go, oh my God, here it comes.
You gotta let him go.
I hope so, because I tell you, I really do, Steve. I love you to death.
Well, Miss Norma, I love you.
Oh, good.
Girl, so I got to tell you, matter of fact, I don't think I've ever been loved this much before.
Oh, God. Lord, I could just go on and on and just love you. Oh, I'm broke your back.
That name show.
Oh, I'm getting right, them muscles.
We got to be quiet. Come on. Yeah. 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 Mama, we got to
run. She was telling me to let you go. Okay.
Please take this answer. I don't care. Whispering things to me you can't hear. I'm scared.
Don't be scared. Don't be scared. Steve, don't be scared.
Okay, I'm trying. Christy, fill in the blank. Raging what?
Ho.
Raging what?
Ho.
Raging ho. What the hell did happen here? Christy, are you going through something? Your other answer the other day, all men are dogs. Now we're talking about this little raging hoe. Who is, what the hell happened, Christy? When you go on a date, name something the guy has that you hope is clean.
Condoms.
Name something that even when it's bad, it's good.
Milk, Steve.
Huh?
Milk. You gotta put it in mashed potatoes. You can't throw that milk away, Steve.
Oh, you're right.
There you go.
Milk.
We gonna play, Steve. Yeah. We gonna play, Steve.
Yeah. Yeah. Name a circus act that reminds you of your man's love-making style. Ashley?
The elephants.
Introduce everybody, Anthony.
Here's my beautiful lesbian, Brooklyn lesbian sister, Maria. Woo! Yeah. How you like me now, Steve?
Name something you might take with you when you go to the bathroom.
A plunger.
Name something you'd like to know about your husband's ex-girlfriends. Alice.
Her bra size.
Name something you try to make smell as nice as possible.
My litter box.
Name something a wife should learn to play so her hubby won't spend so much time with the guys.
Play dead.
Name something your mother-in-law has that's big. Eddie.
A mouth.
Name something about a chicken that might remind you of your wife.
Gobble.
If your man were a stripper, which one of the Seven Dwarfs' names might have staged?
Clumsy.
If you wanted a new picture of yourself, who would you trust to take the picture?
Only person I trust next to my husband would be my mom.
Name something grandma might store under her boobs.
Pistol.
Now give me something to work you wouldn't want your boss to catch you holding.
How about yourself?
Name something of your wife you use when she's not looking.
Her panties. Hey.
Name the itchiest part of your body.
My butt.
Name the itchiest part of your body.
Crotch.
Hey, name something an 80-year-old man might bring with him on a date with a 25-year-old.
An oxygen tank.
Fill in the blank. It would be very bad for a man to dump his woman in the middle of what? Charlie.
A trash can.
Top 6 answers on the board. We asked 100 men. Name a place you might run into your boss where you'd both agree to keep it a secret.
A gay bar.
One answer topic.
Is a strip club the same thing?
Hell no.
Oh, okay.
Besides money, name something a woman might put in a male stripper's G-string.
We're gonna go ahead and put South Kakalaki on the board and say face, her face, Steve. Yes.
What would you do if you ran into your boss at a nude beach?
Spread my towel out and lay out.
Before a man goes to prison, what might he do to make himself really unattractive?
Shave his head.
Shave his head. What that got to do with it? Name something people do to their armpits.
We're gonna go with rub them and put them in someone's face. You know, like, smell. But you know.
Talk to 100 men. In the movies, name something that looks sexier when you see a woman do it in slow motion.
Personally, shooting a gun.
You got it this
time?
I got it.
And if it's not up there, it's not my fault.
Who turn you think it is?
I'm saying you surveying the wrong people if this answer's not up there.
Okay, wait. And this is your chance. There's no way in hell you ain't gonna get one. Here it is. If you design your own coffin, name something you might put in it just in case.
Just in case.
Yes.
A handle to open it up to get out.
A damn dough handle. Fill in the blank. It only hurts when I what?
Pee?
Some men are pigs. What barnyard animal might you compare your man to?
A camel.
What barnyard? No. What desert-dwelling animal might you compare your man to?
Camel.
You stop pointing.
You're sticking with it. You're sticking with it.
Camel. Some men are pigs. What barnyard animal might you compare your man to?
I don't know, Steve. I have to say an elephant.
Which sin do you think people confess most often in confession?
Murder.
Murder? Killing? Thou shalt not kill?
Murder.
Thou shalt not kill, Steve.
Yeah, you keep saying thou shalt not kill.
But it's a sin.
Oh, it's a big one.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a big one. I just don't know how it's a whole bunch of people in there saying it, though.
And I'm the proud owner of my own topless cleaning service, Sunshine Cleaning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who put these people on TV?
My name is Jamie. I'm an attorney in Cleveland, but I love to travel in my free time. I got chased by monkeys once in Malaysia, and so I decided to get over my phobia, and I just Googled at the beginning of the year, world's largest primates, and they said the biggest gorillas are in Uganda and Rwanda, so I'm traveling there next month to get over my fear of monkeys.
That's stupid. That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You don't overcome your fear by going where they got the world's biggest primates at. Are you crazy? They ain't in no cage over there. They loose.
And I am the proud mother of a 13-year-old boy. Hi, Cordell. And I also, 13, yes, and he's quite active.
You don't do that to 13. You do this to babies.
He is
when
my
When you got
baby.
Babies 2, 4, 5, 6, hey, Cordell, you don't do that to the 13-year-old.
No, he's
he
my
got
baby.
Friends. Listen to me. He got friends. He got friends that's going to watch this show. But you can't do it. Wait, my little baby. Hi, Cordell. Cordell is 13. The age limit for doing this to your baby boy on TV is 4, tops. That's it. You do this to the 13-year-old and his friends see it. Oh, God. You done just killed this boy at the school. They're going to be walking down the hallway. Hi, Cordell. Name a part of your lover's body you'd like to eat a chocolate mold of.
His private area.
Well, be damn, Adrian. We just got here. Ain't like you trying to guess the last one. It's 6 answers up there. Name something you might wait to do in a movie theater until the lights go out.
Start videotaping the movie.
Damn, Charlie. Well, I guess the pastor working on the building thing. That came up with a hustle to finally get that new addition built onto the church. Pastor selling bootleg movies right after service.
We don't do it.
Record the movie. All right now, Pastor. Name something some people like to have on when they making love, Pastor.
Well, as a pastor, I believe
no,
in...
No, Adam told you. Do he do this every time? And we're going to go through it every time, every game I have asked him a question. Before he answered the question, he prefaced the answer with some old, well, you know, before I answer that, Steve, Pastor, this don't require no speech. Name a reason a woman in a kissing booth would not want to kiss someone in line.
The breath stink.
The breath. Now, the word is stink. You know, if we're going to sit up in here and be correcting each other, then what you're not going to do is all of a sudden be Miss Bougie over here. Then come here talking about the damn breath stink. Name a word starting with B that describes Kim Kardashian's behind.
Bougie. Bougie.
No.
Bougie.
Yeah, that's what I want to hear. I want to hear what the hell you said at first. One more time.
Bougie.
The old whole family from the hood. You want to talk to 100 men? Give me a part of your body with hair you've never cut or trimmed.
You're a tush.
Yeah!
One of them pink lady bics. Name something people wash once a week.
Your tail, your washing
I tell you
my
what,
hand.
You wait once a week to wash that puppy right there. I tell you what, I don't want you on none of my chairs at my house, okay? And draws just burst into flames.
Who works for the CDC over there?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
What? Oh, Center for Disease Control.
Center for Disease Control.
Yeah, because she handled Ebola, though. Which one you work with?
I work in finance. So
oh, see, you ain't really. See, you ain't, See, you ain't really handling disease.
No.
You send payments
out. I don't
out.
Mind shaking your hand.
No, that one right there, she's an epidemiologist.
Yes.
What is it?
Epidemiologist.
What?
Epidemics, epidemiologist.
Oh, like that cleared it up. Epidemics. Epidemics, epidemiology. Oh, no. You meant to send naked pictures to your beloved, but they accidentally went to who?
Your lover.
You know, your answers shouldn't be the same word that's in the question. Oh, no, you meant to send naked pictures to your beloved, but who did they accidentally went to? Your lover. Hey, Tammy.
Hello.
If your dog got into the Viagra, name something in your house that wouldn't be safe.
I'm going to say your vacuum cleaner hose. Oh.
Right. Yeah, kitty, kitty. Kitty, kitty. Come on, little Fluffy. Come here, Fluffy. Bring your little Fluffy cell phone over here. The cat. Larry, talk to 100 men. Name the first part of a woman you touch to get her in the mood. Let's quit playing, Larry.
Let's play. That would be the lower front or the vagina. I didn't want to say it.
You ain't want to say it.
I didn't want to say it.
Man, you know what's happening on that. You know, good hair, well, that ought to be number one. He said the lower front. Yeah, down there on the prairie. Down there by Homeland Security. Down there by the promised land. Down there, where the deer and the antelope play. Home, home, home on the range. Land of the free. Home of the brave. Down there in the lower front. The 40 acres and a mule. Down front. Matter of fact, I recommend when you buy them, ladies, try to buy one two sizes small. I'm talking about where it can't hardly nothing stay in there. Just have it where it just you just come out. All right, name something you might text your boss about because you're too chicken to tell her in person.
I'm sleeping with one of the employees.
Oh.
Why would you text that to anybody? Let alone your boss. Hey, well,
I mean, you got to get it out there.
You got to get it out there.
You might as well put it out there, man. You know, you
can. Boy, you've been self-employed too damn long. You ain't had a job for nobody. Boy, that's sexual harassment. That's against most. That's against every company policy in the world.
It's a preemptive strike. You got to do it before it gets you.
It's a preemptive strike.
Yeah, you gotta.
Who told you that?
You gotta get out there before it attacks you.
It ain't got nothing to do with it being no preemptive strike. That you just said is just stupid. Your boss be sitting there going, what in the world did he text me that for? I didn't text you. That's a preemptive strike.
Jay, name a part of your body that might hit you in the face when you're bouncing on a trampoline.
I'm going to say your thighs.
Your thighs. The same as your leg. They're going to put that on all on the whole leg thing. Leg, knee, all that. Same.
All right, I'm going to say your shoulder.
Yeah, well, that's good, but you... They already said.
Okay, I'm gonna say your fingers.
Yeah. Let me guess, you're gonna say your arm next, right? And then after that, Jay, you might as well say your damn hair. Just get your stomach in there too, Jay. Let's say that. Hey, I got your milk jugs. How about that? All right, Jay, we got them all out the way, buddy. Let's go. Name part of your body that might hit you in the face when you're bouncing on a trampoline.
Shoulders.
That's all right, honey.
We gonna go down here one more time. Jay, you can't say nothing else that's on this damn board. I've never seen a person get more wrong answers on just his turn. This just Jay's turn. Jay, I'm gonna stand next to you. Cause man, obviously, it's the reason they put you way down here in the fifth spot. They knew. Now, Jay, come on, man, cause we could do this, man. Come on. On TV, man. You ride. Thank you. Think about you out on that Harley and you riding. Boy, you sweating hard as hell. Come on, hang in there, Jay. Jay, let me tell you something. Let's take another shot. You're going to read it with me. Name a part of your body that might hit you in the face when you're bouncing on the trampoline.
I'm going to say your tail end.
I like your ass.
All right. Your ass.
That's what we're going with. You done jumped, bam, in your face. Do you know how big your ass got to be for you to jump and then somebody's going, that's the best answer I heard, Jay. Man, thank you for coming, Jay. You just made my whole day. Yo, tail end! Oh, Pentecostal. Yeah, I grew up Pentecostal.
Oh, amen.
Church of God in Christ.
Okay.
Yeah, I grew up in that. Yeah, I know that. The drums, tambourine, track meet, all of it.
Yeah.
Take your mark. Get set. Pow!
Praise him, Stick. Praise him, Stick.
It was only cracking in my shirt. All I was doing was sitting up there writing jokes, going to hell.
I'm cold, and there are wolves after me.